Let's start the second topic for this session. See, Modigliani and Miller approach, important assumptions need to keep in mind the perfectly capital market. Perfectly capital market means companies are same in all the aspects as except their capital structure. So how do we find out the value of the companies when they only differ in their capital structure? See, one may have debt and equity both in their capital structure, other may only have equity in its capital structure. So when you have debenture, it increases your risk. So when you have increases in risk, we call it as leverage. So one is a levered firm, which does not have debentures in its capital, so it does not have any risk. It is an unlevered firm. So we see the two types of firm. One is a levered, other is an unlevered. How do you find out the value of a levered firm and unlevered firm? Let us do this with a small illustration under Modigliani and Miller approach. The two firms A and B, which are exactly identical, except that A has not used any debt in its financing, while B has 2,50,000, 6% debentures in its financing. So A is a unlevered firm, B is a levered firm. Both the firm have EBIT of 75,000 and cost of equity is 10%. Assuming the corporate taxation is 50%, calculate the value of the firm. Need to find the value of two companies, value of A and value of B. Let's start with the value of A. Now, we know when the company only has equity in its capital structure, we do not take debentures into consideration, which approach is highlighting, or net operating income approach, right? And as I said, Modigliani is just an extension of a bit. So, value of a company is what? EBIT divided by cost of capital, right? Or cost of equity. So, if you only have equity, you can't say value, debentures are there in your capital structure. And I studied three approaches. Study net income, study net operating income, is so traditional. Net income approach is debentures and equity both. Net operating income takes only equity. Traditional just a midway between the two. So, if you have only equity, which approach are you highlighting, or net operating income? So, use net operating income to find the value of the unlevered firm. So, value of the company will be over here, will be EBIT divided by cost of equity or cost of capital. Cost of capital will be equal to cost of equity in this case. How much is the EBIT given to us? EBIT given to us in this case, you can see 75,000. Cost of equity given to us is 10%. So 75,000 divided by 10% gives us how much? Value of the company for firm A, that is 7,50,000. Keep your concept strong before we start now. Now, can you find the value of firm B based on value of firm A? Now, value of firm B, if you see what? Both the companies are same, only difference is that B also have debentures in its capital structure. So, value of firm A will be equal to value of firm B. Only thing, B also has capital debentures in its capital structure. So, how do you find the value of a levered firm? Value of a leveraged firm will be what? Value of an unleveraged firm add of debentures into tax rate. This is a formula which we use to find out is the value of a leveraged firm. So value of a leveraged firm, how will you do it? Value of an unleveraged firm, how much you got was 7,50,000. Debentures are how much in this case given to you is 2,50,000. Tax rate is 50%. So 50% of 2,50,000 gives you 1,25,000. So using this formula, value for a leveraged firm will be value of unleveraged plus tax into debentures. Find out the value of an unleveraged firm. 7,50,000 plus 1,25,000 gives you 8,75,000. So you can derive the value of a leveraged firm with the help of a value of an unleveraged firm. And this is what Modigliani and Miller spoke about. Modigliani and Miller have two perspectives. Practically, taxes you can't ignore. That's why I have taken taxes into account when I talk about debentures. So use a formula and do it accordingly when you do Modigliani and Miller approach. Keeping your previous theories correct, Modigliani and Miller just makes it more clear how practically things happen in the market. So we have two firms, leveraged and unleveraged firm, who only differ in the capital structure, and when they differ in the capital structure, risk element comes into picture.